Hi, everybody. I'm here in the Hacienda Music Room, and I'm here to teach you the dance steps to our dance, New York, New York. I've got my top hat, my bow tie, and my makeshift cane, but you can use anything for a cane. I found a round wooden dowel, and I painted it black and put some white tips on it, but you can use a pointer stick, you can use a yardstick, as your cane. You can even use an umbrella, but you do need something to act like a cane for this because we will be utilizing it in the dance. So today when I do the dance for you, I'm going to be facing the camera and I want you to mirror most of my moves. I will explain how to do the dance later, but for now, pretend that the audience is actually behind me. And if I say move to the right, that's gonna be moving to your right. Or if I say hold your cane up with your left hand, it's gonna be your left hand. So kind of just basically copy the direction that I'm going and you'll learn the dance that way. If at the end of the video I have more things to explain, I'll probably do that later. I'll do the whole dance through. And then after that, I'll break it down section by section and talk about how to do it. And for that situation, I might turn myself around as if you're dancing. So the song starts off with our two groups, or you can make it even more if you want to. If you are not a Hacienda student, but you're using this video for your group to learn New York, New York, you can come from any direction. But we are coming from one of two directions. Some of us are coming from the left, some of us are coming from the right, and we're listening to the song and taking steps that match it. So it's a quick, quick, slow. So if we were coming from the side here, we would be doing quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, and probably taking much bigger steps than I'm demonstrating to get us all the way to where our dance spots are. And then we're gonna have our cane right out in front so that we're ready to begin the dance. So I'm gonna step off to the side and walk in as if I'm somebody on the dance floor as well. And why don't we just get started?
Start spreading the
sway. Now grapevine to the right.
A part of it. New York,
with a little
New
tap
York.
And a cane push out.
These vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step around the heart of it. New York, New York. I wanna wake up.
First. rainbow arms. Always start kicking on your right foot. Canes up, then go down on your right knee, and your right hand holds the cane. Hey, you did it! Great job. All right, now let's break down the dance into sections. Maybe I'll come in from the other side just to give you an idea, but we're going to start the quick slows and make our way to the middle. So I'm going to start on the side, and I'm going to start my quick slow. If I get to my spot early, I can just keep doing my quick slows until everybody gets here and the music changes. You'll hear the sound of the music kind of give a nice strong beginning. That's when you're going to want to have your cane straight out and get ready to start swaying. We're going to sway 8 times, starting on the right, and it's a kind of a nice slow sway. 5, 6, 7, and 8. Then we go right into a grapevine, right and left, for a total of 4. And a grapevine is done with a step behind step, and then tap and push your cane out, and then step behind step, tap, step behind step, and step behind step. All right, after you get that part done, the word says these vagabond shoes. So you're going to take your cane. I like to hold it in my right hand when I do it because I'm going to tap my right shoe first. So I'm going to turn around backwards as if you're dancing. So just literally copy what I'm doing. These vagabond, let me get back over here, shoes. We tap each shoe and then we put our cane down right in the center. So you're going to tap your right shoe, your left shoe, and then center your cane and wait for the words, are longing to stray. Stray is the key word that you're going to want to take your cane with your right foot, and you're going to kick your cane up and use your hands to guide it up to your right shoulder. So these vagabond shoes, right, left, and down, are longing to stray. And then when you get it to your shoulder, you're going to walk in a clockwise motion. Okay, until you face the audience again. And then it says, and step around the heart of it. So at that point, you're still kind of walking, and you're going to say, and step around. So your feet do a shuffle. It goes like this, shuffle, step. And your arms literally go around in a circle, and they end on the side. So it goes, and step around the heart of it in old New York. We do it a total of 4 times, and we go, that's our 4th. So the trick on that one is to actually start when it says round. Round is when you're going to want to take your right foot and lead the shuffle step and lead your cane around in a circle. Okay? After you finish and step around the heart of it, our next part is, I want to wake up in the city that doesn't sleep. So wake up is straight up with both hands. In the city, that's our left hand, that doesn't, I let go of the cane up here and catch it with my right hand. I put my right hand on it, and then I'm going to walk around in a clockwise motion again. So let me do it with you this time. I want to wake up in the city that doesn't sleep. So on sleep is when I definitely have to have my cane down, okay? And then it's kind of interesting because this is the part where you're going to actually do some poses. The first time through, we do 2 poses. King of the Hill, I think is it, and the word king is where we stop and pose. I've been choosing this one for some reason, but any pose will do. You can step out, you can put your hands up, but we are gonna switch different poses, so you've gotta choose. And this is where it gets to be fun, because you'll see some creativity from everybody else who's doing the dance. You don't have to do the same poses. Unless you are a non-hacienda person using this for yourself, maybe you would like to use the same poses. Anyway, you're gonna choose and you're gonna freeze in whatever pose you've done. And then when we get to the word heap, it's kind of a long wait. You've gotta wait for heap, and then you're going to top of the heap, make another pose, whatever it is, all right? After that, we do my Little Town Blues. And at that point, you're going to want to step towards the audience, and you're going to take your right foot first, and it's going kind of, you tap it out with your toe, and then your heel comes down as a step. And then you go to the other foot. Tap out and down, tap and down, tap and down. We do that going towards the audience. So I'm coming towards you right now, but actually I should be going backwards. So if I did that with you, my right foot would start you see that tap down. So my Little Town Blues, down, tap, down, tap, down, melting away, and we push and we move away from the audience. So we kind of bring our cane around and back here. After we come back to our spots after the four counts, we turn to the right, and you're going to always keep your cane closest to the audience. So in this case, if we turn right, we're going to keep our cane in our left hand, and our right hand and our right foot are the two that we're going to use to begin kicking over here. So we're going to kick, down for four. Here's our fourth one. And because we want to keep our cane towards the audience, we're going to switch hands. Now our cane is still out there. And now we're going to use our other hand to shake. But we still use our right foot to kick. So it's kick, down. We're looking out to the audience. By the time you get to your fourth kick here, you might not even get it all the way finished. You're going to hear the final part, if I can make it there. So you're going to take your cane, if I can make it there. We're going to actually hit and tap our cane each word. I'll make it anywhere. It's up to, we bring our cane, and then when we say, you, New York, New York. And we're just going to keep on kicking the first time through, because it's going to bring us back to and step around the heart of it. Don't worry until you hear the word round, because that's when you're going to want to go back around with your shuffle step to the right and back and two more times. And then we start basically repeating all of it again. Okay? So, You do the wake up in the city that doesn't sleep, and find I'm king of the hill, cream of the crop. I think I'm getting the words wrong, but there's four poses in that. And we have to wait again for top of the heap. And then you're going to come forward, my little town blues, tap again, and then push away. I'm melting away, and turn. Da, 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 four kicks, and switch with your hand in the right and front. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York, New York. And then at the very end, we bring our cane up and we come down. Now don't land on your knee. My trick is to come down like I'm almost on my knee, and then set my knee down. Otherwise, it's going to be too painful. So you'll lift up your cane. Right hand's going to hold it when we come down, and our right knee is the one that's going to go down. New York, and then down, and we hold it like a V and face the audience. Whew, I think we got through the whole thing. So good luck practicing, and I'm eager to see you perform it for me in class. And of course, our guests and parents and everybody who will be coming to Kids in Motion. So good luck practicing.